Now we're ready for our second competitor. Competitor number two is Oyindamola Okuwa, and she is from the Department of Sociology. The title of this presentation is Women's Decision-Making Power and Contraceptive Use in Nigeria. So thank you.
Nigeria is Africa's most populous nation. In her lifetime, a Nigerian woman is expected to give birth to 5.5 children on average. Now, despite this high fertility rate, one in 22 Nigerian women will die during childbirth. Now, this is alarmingly high when you compare it to the one in 4,900 women who die during childbirth in most developed nations. Another interesting contradiction in the Nigerian reproductive health space is this. Despite this high maternal mortality, Nigeria consistently ranks low in contraceptive uptake. In fact, in 2018, only 14% of Nigerian women use any form of contraceptives. Now, contraceptives are important because they serve as a way for a woman to assert autonomy over her own reproduction. They're a form of resistance to patriarchy, and they're a stellar way to reduce maternal deaths and total fertility rates. These indices were some of the things that drove my interest in understanding the mechanisms behind contraceptive use in Nigeria. Using demographic health survey, I investigate the factors that influence contraceptive use among women in Nigeria, and the results I find are very interesting. I find that women's decision-making power is perhaps the most important factor influencing contraceptive use among women in Nigeria. Specifically, I find that when women can make their own healthcare and financial decisions, they are more likely to use contraceptives. Now, let me break this down a bit. I find that 23.5% of women who make their own financial decisions will use contraceptives, and only 9% of those whose husbands or partners make their financial decisions will use contraceptives. And this result was similar for healthcare decision and when I controlled for education and other factors. The result of this is simply clear. Women's decision-making power matters. Now, you might ask me, why should I care? Why should I care about women in Nigeria? I am African, and I firmly believe in the concept of Ubuntu, which means I am, because we are. Until women across the world, whether from Nepal or from Chad or from Niger Republic or from Nigeria, can achieve their full potential, can see a reduction in maternal deaths, can see an improvement in the quality of life that they live, we cannot truly say we have developed as a global sphere. Women's decision-making power matters. It matters for women in Nigeria, and it matters for women across the world. And my research will serve to shape and influence policy on this. Thank you very much.